Right guys, this is a perfect example of how to prepare your pond ready for the fiberglassing. A good strong marquee. I've said it before, and I'll say it a million times again. None of them crappy little gazebos you get from a garden centre for 20 or 30 quid. It'll be perfectly weathertight, nicely shaded. Sometimes if the sun comes through and hits the pond, maybe just put a bit of paper up there or a little tarp just to shade it so we don't get any streaks of sun. See like what we've got over there? It's nowhere near intense enough to do anything detrimental to it at the minute, but that's just for future reference. Build your walls nice and flat like that, not like burglar bond that I turn up to sometimes where you can climb up the inside to get out of them. Leave your pipes proud by a few inches. I'll glass onto them, cut them off and grind them back. Fit your bottom drain flush. Make sure there's no water pouring all into it. Nice and dry like that. Skimmer, you can pull it back flush to the wall or leave it slightly proud. I'll work around whatever you leave. Window, make sure that's well in. I'm going to foam up to this one and then we're going to be glassing over the aluminium frame. What you don't ever want to do is rely on that bad advice that this is ground up. You know, this isn't even ground up. And even if it was ground up with a machine to give it a supposed key, the fiberglass will peel away from that and you'll have water pissing straight down the back of the fiberglass given time. So you either want to come, finish the fiberglass here, and lock it in place with some sealant that you put the window in with, or, as we're doing in this case, coming right up to this lip here. Nice flat floor. Basically, just do a nice job.